Hello, my friends, and welcome back, everyone, to 7 Days to Die on PC. Today we're returning, and it's the final night before bad things start to happen. What bad things? Well, to be exact, a horde of 7 days is going to come and actually just poop on us very hard. So, one thing that I saw, you know what? No distractions. First things first, we're getting that forge done. We also have so much sand, but we're getting a forge done. We got 20 leather. We just got to get to the bellos. Hello, bellos. We're going to craft those up for the next 40 seconds. While that's going on, maybe a small amount of organization here or there. I don't really know. We still have the really cool night vision goggles. Let's toss those on for fun. I actually want to see what these things are like. What does this do? What can possibly... Okay, never mind. Take that off. Oh my god. Just became a lot darker. It's not headgear. Oh, it's that. Oh, okay. If we hit F. Oh, spooky. This doesn't really help like the most in the world, but sure, I guess, if we want to be like all Splinter Cell like. That's cool though. We can actually hold up. Oh no, we kind of messed up our crafting there. What I wanted to ask here real quick, right? Does this have better armor ratings and stuff than our current shades? The answer is I actually don't think so. Wow. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of swap those out real quick. We're going to put the mining helmet back on so we can actually see. Awesome. Thank you. I love this thing because I'm too lazy to actually ever invest in real lighting. And from here, we got to get as much wood as possible. That's going to be our number one priority. We can't craft anything. We could craft a 44 Magnum once we find the book. We need ammo and stuff though, but that's a whole nother story. We can get to cooking some stuff. We do have some chicken noodle soup here. Crushed sand. I'm gonna put that away. Which one's the garbage chest? This will be. I don't even know. I'll make this the garbage chest. And I know stuff respawns here. Just has to be after a certain amount of time. I don't have to worry about it respawning anytime soon. But in the meantime, I will be putting away a lot of our stuff here. Let's just kind of try and save up on some storage. Then we got the AK parts we can put away. Nails and stuff. Stones we'll keep. Actually, really quick. What can we craft out of sand? Can we craft anything out of it? Or we can make sandbags. Okay. They're not sturdy, but... I mean, why the hell... Oh... No, never mind. That takes up other stuff. And we can make crushed sand into sand. I don't know how that makes a difference. Can we place sand? Because I wouldn't mind just having a ton of blocks and like surrounding our place. That'll give us 167. We'll see if we can do that. Let's max craft that in the meantime. Oh god, that's going to be crafting. Never mind. No, we got better stuff to do first. We want to get the forge going. Get the forge. All we need is the rest of that clay, which we got. And the forge is in sight. Woot woot. Hell to the yes. So we are looking fantastic right now. We still got plenty of shovels that we were digging stuff up with. Still gonna put away like the electric components and other stuff that we don't necessarily need. Now we'll start crafting the crushed sand into sand or something. Small stone can become crushed. Like, I don't know how this exactly works. I don't know, but maybe I don't know. We'll do something with it. I don't want to use my cloth, though. I would rather save that up. So, you got a bunch of the glass jars. I forgot to fill those up yesterday or last time. Whoops. But it's not too big of a deal there. And if we just keep on, I'll just drop the sand. That's not too big of a deal. And then if we keep on keeping on, let's eat a little bit of chicken noodle here. Get our food and hydration up. Speaking of that, our food is kind of struggling a little bit. We probably want to cop a little bit of that. I'll just keep on eating the chicken noodle here because that'll bring it up. And as we eat, our health does go up as well, which is great news. We can then start scrapping that. I think we can put away the short iron pipes too. We don't need those a whole ton. We're about to start smelting down a lot of this iron though. And then hopefully we can get those metal tools like I was mentioning. And then once we have the metal tools, we should be able to break into a certain somewhere a lot easier. So what we can do here is grab all of... I'm not going to do all of it. I'll do like... How do I grab half? Oh, it's right click. There we go. And we'll put that into there for smelting. Actually, we will split that in half. That should make it even quicker. And I do not want to do too much wood just because I want to use like 500 for actually crafting and whatnot. Especially because we got a good amount of stuff we want to craft. Okay, so small stone. What recipes can I make out of you? Give me what recipes here? Cobblestone, destroyed stone, the adobe stuff, which I don't really know how that's going to go. Concrete would be dope, but that's going to be a while. Okay, so while this is crafting, after a while, we should be able to start doing forged iron. We can start doing forged iron eventually. Can we not? Hold the fuck. Why can't we? Where's iron? I don't see forged iron. Am I blind? I am blind. Okay, we're good. We're good. Titties. We need clay in here too, don't we? Well, we're not going to be able to craft up the most at the time being here. I'm also going to kind of put those back together. Put the clay in there. Actually, no. That'll give us a max of 49. So we'll come back in a little bit. Do that. In the meantime, just making sure our current inventory is good. Might store away some of the shovels just because we don't need them at the moment. We'll probably need them eventually, but store some of those away. Keep the stones. Maybe craft that into like destroyed stone. All that's just going to get destroyed even harder. We do have the sand. So is this the placeable sand? That's what. Okay, that's the placeable sand. So we can like kind of bury our surroundings in this if we want. We might do that. Okay. Well, other than that, we got to start figuring out where to get some wood from, because that's the one thing we're kind of really short on and we would enjoy more. So I think we've gotten like all the old chairs out of here. We're not going to be getting any more in that department. Yeah, no. That might be all the wood we can get. That's kind of going to suck because I was thinking we reinforce that area. We could collapse this. I don't know how that's going to go. I don't know. I mean, we definitely do have to replace this with just something, you know, because this stuff is concrete. That's going to be worth a lot of hits. We should be able to survive that a good amount. If we had a shotgun already, that'd be great. And after the 7-day horde, we might start moving to the north because we've already checked out like everything around here. And then I'd want to start moving up north, seeing what's up there. I think that'll be a good call because there's still a lot more stuff that's been added that I do want to explore. In the meantime, I mean, we could try breaking this down. No, that's not worth it. Is anything here worth it? Okay, so this stuff we kind of get wood out of. I'll just start breaking this. Like, sure, the camo's probably gonna break and that's cool, but no, never mind. That stuff is sturdy as hell, surprisingly enough. Jesus Christ. Anyways, go ahead, try to break through as much of this as possible. And then when this is good to, we could break that down too, but I like those. Those are very decorative and nice. So I think if I break this down, this thing should still stay up. We're also seriously in the whole scheme of things getting almost no wood whatsoever, but no, never mind. All of it fell. Well, rip. We got a lot of cloth though. I don't know if it's a lot, but we got some cloth. All right. I mean, that's a good excuse to get rid of the rest of this stuff. And then after I get some of this wood, we're really not getting a lot. It's like 4 wood per thing, but there's no trees, man. We live in the desert. It's a hard knocked life. Like, does breaking this give us more wood? No, and this thing's already broken as hell. Well, titties. All right. So back here, we do need to get this thing going a little bit more. We'll get it going with like another 8 there, and then max craft some forged iron, and now we should be able to craft some pickaxes. And all that awesome iron stuff. There's still that gun safe we're going to break into. And we will be pretty damn productive. Now then, once that's done, I would say we want to go somewhere to get some wood. The closest wood supply is very, very far away. That's not happening, unfortunately, guys. I'm sorry. Yeah, so we're just going to try to get as much forged iron as possible. And whenever that stuff's done, how much do we need for a pickaxe? Pickaxe. 20. We need 20. Why does it say I have that much? I am so confused right now. Oh, don't I have to? I think I have to learn how to craft them too. Is that a thing? I think I might have to do that. Okay, let's do, I think it'd be under like tools and traps. Maybe toolsmithing, is that? Maybe? I don't know. We'll see once we actually get enough forged iron. Because it's really weird how that's happening. I don't know why it's being like that. Yeah, so we just got to wait. We're going to have to add in some more wood. We'll do like 8 more then. Never. Oh. There we go. That should be enough. We'll do 8 more. That should help us get enough iron for this whole predicament. We'll probably put away the night vision goggles. These aren't the best in the world. I don't even know why, if they're going to be useful. We still got water and stuff. If we really need food, we can go vampire mode, eat some blood bags. Again, I don't advocate that, but we can do that if need be. And we still got a couple extra wood frames here. Probably want to start breaking into stuff and everything. Yeah, something like that. Okay, so let's take this, scrap you. And that'll get scrapped eventually. We do need to make a new one. Stone axe, right? I can't even make you. I gotta find plant fibers. Do I have plant fibers in here or did I throw them all out? I threw out all my plant fibers. God damn it. And there's no plant fibers in here. That's okay. It's about to be daytime anyway. We'll be nice and safe. I do want to get rid of this door just because doors draw unwanted attention. The zombies have learned that doors are a sign of civilization. And I really have to sneeze. Oh. Just kidding, that was a yawn. What the f- I've never gotten those two mixed up before. I mean, I guess if we really are desperate for wood, we can go around breaking bushes, but I don't think we're that desperate yet. And, like, we can break this thing. Like, I don't know if using a wrench is the most effective thing in the world, but, like, it kind of works. You go, wrench. You go. I mean, sure. Screw it. Let's use our wrench to get some wood. I mean, it makes sense. You could, if you hit something hard enough with a wrench, it's bound to, like, break into smaller craftable fragments, so I don't judge. All right, there we go. We got a little bit of wood out of that. Good news, good news. Still not enough for us to really do anything productive with, but we can also craft up a normal stone axe. I would do an iron one. We're not going to have the iron, though, just because I'm being conservative with my wood right now. So... yeah, that thing's already done being all molten and crap. And if we go to our pickaxe. Hold up. Our pickaxe. Actually. No, wait. Okay, so pickaxe, right? Iron pickaxe, we're good. Crafting up one of you. No, we're not. Okay, screw the sand. Crafting up the pickaxe. It's gonna take 3 minutes to craft that thing? Why? I've never seen... Okay, you know, you do you. In the meantime, I'm just going to go start trying to break this stuff apart, crafting up the wood frames, and then seeing what we can do with this. And in terms of how much sand we have 43. So I'll probably just, like, since that'll be a bit weaker, I'll do, like, a layer of sand outside of it. And I'm going to start with the other one. And then I still want wood to make spikes, though. Yeah, so, what I might ultimately end up doing... I might literally fill this area in with just a bunch of sand and then use all of our wood just on as many spikes as possible. That might be the best plan of attack. And then if we get broken into, I'll, like, climb up onto the roof of a building, the other building, the one that we're not in, and we'll try to fend for our lives from up there. I think that's a good plan. We'll get iron from breaking this stuff, which is good. I'll leave that up there, I guess. Barbed wire is good. I mean, it does barbed things. And yeah, I mean, we got 2 wood frames. I don't know what we're going to use that for exactly, but sure. I think we'll maybe start in the watchtowers, try to snipe some zombies from up there with our hunting rifle, and then see how things escalate from there. Might be the best plan of action. Oh, look at that. Easy peasy. Well, actually, no, because now we got to break that. Oh, that's a little bit easier to break now that I think about it. Okay, sure thing. Yeah, so if we break all the bottom one, okay, that'll be a quicker way. Iron pick, how you do? Yeah, that's not doing too hot. Now then, like I was saying, actually, can I? I can. Okay, so I don't even know why I'm breaking this down. We could be doing stuff in addition to this. See, I like, we could have been, this is a little bit better, because we can put sand on both sides of this, I think? No, it's only one side. I don't even know. What the hell? It's kind of glitchy like that. Hold on, I'm going to see where I can put sand then. Can I put it anywhere? No, only certain ones? What the hell? This is odd to say the least. Also, I'm going to turn off my flashlight. It's really bright. Yeah, this is... Okay, never mind. We do have to keep on breaking this. God damn it, I thought I found a shortcut. I mean, the good news again, I think we get like 11 or so total stuff out of all this. Not stuff, what's the word I'm looking for? You guys know the word, iron. We get like that much scrap iron out of this stuff, so that's gonna be good. The thing is, it's gonna be annoying. Once you get the iron pick, that should speed things up by a lot. And we still do have all the perk points we probably want to put into stuff, so I'm gonna do that. Let's do that while this thing finishes up. So in terms of perk points, okay, let's see what we can do. The survivor. So is your metabolism. We're kind of low on food. I'm gonna keep on surviving. I think that's a good one to invest in. The camel, running, no, I don't think so. Fixer, nah, health nut. Raises your minimum and max wellness by 10 points per rank. Not too shabby. That actually might be kind of solid, but I don't think I'm going to do it. I think we just finished our iron pick as well. Pummel Pete's. I don't think really doing pummeling stuff. What else can we unlock? Mining 69er. We have rifles. No scavenging. No. Quality Joe is going to be a good one. Yes. Definitely Quality Joe. That's a good, that's always a good one to invest in. Boomstick eventually, because I love shotguns. And Treasure Hunter. Oh, no. Oh, look at that. Traders of a Secret Stash. What the hell? Right, we still got 15 points. I don't know how often we're going to be finding treasure, so I don't know if I'm even going to want to get that. That would make it easier once we do find it. Maybe next time we find one, I'll like invest in that. Other than that, though, I mean, in terms of perks, I want to go up into pistol. We don't even have a goddamn pistol. This is my rifle. More damage. I mean, we do have a rifle, so to hell with it. I'll get that. That's like our go-to. How much ammo do we have for this again? 48. That's really good, actually, for what we're trying to do. We're actually in a pretty good situation ammo-wise, so I think we have a solid chance. Oh my god, this makes life so much easier. I'm going to be really salty once this thing breaks down, though. Look at that, though. We just eat through the stuff. It makes it so much better. And then if we break through this bottom piece, I think the fences above it should just fall down, right? I might be mistaken there, but no, they're not falling down. Okay. So I'm going to, yeah, that's the goal. Finish these two fences, replace them with other stuff. I mean, like, is sand, I don't think sand's as durable as a fence, though. So I don't know what I'm thinking there. I mean, the zombies are easily going to break through a fence, though. And they're also really weird, because this way we can kind of make a two layers of sand and see how that goes. I just want to put my sand to good use, man. That's all I want in life. I just want to use my sand. Yeah, so as you can see there, this is what I wanted to do with the sand. Just literally a blockade of sand. Why can I not put it there? That doesn't even make sense. Oh, because there's technically a fence there. My god, the thing's buried in all of this. Okay, I'll break that fence. That's probably gonna make the sand fall. That's whatever. Speaking of that, while this is all going on, let's definitely continue our sand. There we go. Let's keep on crafting. I can't do it that way. There we go. 96 more sand. It didn't fall. Thank god for that. Voila. I'll leave that there. I might as well make it like three tall. But that's what I'm gonna do. Just a giant mass of sand. It's not gonna be as effective as a fence, but it's multiple layers, which is why I kind of like it. I don't know. Okay, so now we just got to break into this thing. Oh man, we're only doing like 30 per hit. How much does the stone axe do? It's like gonna be three times as quick, so that's okay. It's gonna use up a lot of hits on our stone axe, or not our stone axe, our iron axe, which kind of sucks. But I mean, we're already 20% of the way done, so it's not gonna be too bad. Anyways, I should probably take this opportunity. Do something I should have done a while ago. Hopefully all of you guys are having yourselves an awesome goddamn day. Me, myself, I'm doing okay. I'm doing okay. You know, I just gotta, after this thing's done, I gotta go start cranking out some homework. The homework life in college, let me say, it is not fun. I have so much. I don't even know. Oh my god, I don't even want to think about it right now. But yeah, I'm gonna start getting to work on that because I just have so much. And hopefully then I can get a good chunk of that done tonight, and then I work on the rest tomorrow. Oh man, I don't know. If any of you guys are in college, I don't know, you can let me know in the comments, but let me know if you know this struggle that I speak of, because I know some of you guys have to know this struggle. Oh man, classic college struggle. So I can't wait for this semester to be over, go home for winter break, relax. Oh my god, I'm like fantasizing about it, because right now I'm about like halfway done. It's like about to be week 8, so we're getting close. I'm getting close at least, so cheer me on, guys. I love like seeing you guys' comments and tweets every once in a while. It's like super positive and stuff and kind of cheering me on. That stuff's awesome, you know. I actually do appreciate that a ton. And we got a bunch of weapon parts here. Okay. We'll see if any of those overlap with what we currently have going. And if they do, we might be able to craft something. I doubt it, but like pistol frame, this one's worse. Scrap it. Hunting rifle parts. We don't have any hunting rifle stuff, so that's kind of good. Actually, what kind of receiver? Oh no, that's all yellow quality. I still can't believe we found such a great hunting rifle at the start. It's probably rigged, so you always start with one. And then, oh, what the hell? Oh, we got, we found the last 44 Magnum stuff. I guess we didn't have all the 44 Magnum stuff. I swear to God we had a frame before. Okay, so I'm gonna scrap those parts. I think we're good there. Yeah, okay, just making sure. Poopy shotgun receiver, scrap you up. Brass put you away, and I think that's pretty much everything we got, and then some old cash. I still don't know what exactly old cash is used for. Let me know if I can do anything with that. Otherwise, I think I can just scrap it into paper, and that's not the most useful thing in the world until we have to do shotgun shells. But yeah, I don't know, we'll see in that department. So we got to get a amount of time to go. While all of this is going on, I'm actually going to stop crafting the sandbags, and let's go ahead and go on to spikes. These things are going to be hella important. Wait. Am I reading that right? 100 wood for... Huh? I'm gonna craft one just to see. You're joking, right? What? What? Oh boy. They did not used to be this expensive. Well, where'd they even get? Wait. What? Is this a joke? Is this a joke? Are you? That's 100. What? All right, boys. Well, my plan just got derailed very, very hard. We're going to be making these normal spikes. Crap. Oh, my God. We are so screwed. Oh, my God. That is really bad. Okay, so following this development where I have way less spikes available to me than I initially thought, let me know in the comment section. I might ditch the military base and just try to survive this in the hotel. That might be a better plan. Because right now, this is bad. It used to be like 10 wood for a spike. Now it's 100. I should be able to make like 40 spikes at this point. You know how many I got? Fucking 4 if I wanted. Well, that kind of derails things by a lot. And that is really, really bad. And our food's going really, really down. And we probably... Okay. Pause and think for a sec. I've looted a lot of the areas near here. Actually, no, we don't have to pause. Let's go to the map for a sec. And since various I haven't looted, I don't think I've looted up that store. Okay. Important stuff that I do need you guys' input on. We are really low on food right now. As in, we have no food right now. I'm going to be starving soon. But there's a 7-day horde coming. I would love to fortify the base, but there's not much with which to fortify. I don't have any food. There's no wood out here. We messed up. I thought I could get by. Ah! Don't even, like... I know, like, some people sometimes say, like, oh my god, Star is so stupid. Like, don't even give me that with the spikes. I know that the spikes used to be cheaper than that. Oh my god. Well, rip us or something or other like that. Yeah, wish us luck, because we're really going to need it. Other than that, give me any advice that we should do for next episode in the comment section down below, and wish me all the luck in the world. I'm going to need it. But other than that, that's going to go ahead and do it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and goodbye, my friends.